MCQ 30 is a question of electrochemistry with quite an interesting twist to it. Starting off by having a piece of copper which is square with the dimension of 0.1 by 0.1 meter. So just drawing it out here first. And to that, we are to place copper atoms onto it. So with the following assumption that each copper atoms have a cube of length 3 times 10 power negative 12 meter, and the piece of copper that we are trying to coat has no thickness and there's a uniform coverage. So visually seeing itself, I want to put small pieces of copper onto this piece of square copper. So let me just complete the circles over here. Again, there should not be any more gaps because copper is actually a solid. And then after that, the last criteria here is that this new piece of copper that has been coated with additional pieces of copper must have a total depth of 1000 atoms. Now do note that there are two interpretations of how this question could be done. Either you can have 500 on top and another 500 layers of copper at the bottom to give a total net depth of 1000 atoms, which is the first way that I will be doing for this question, and therefore there's actually two answers. Or another interpretation in this question here is that we are going to have a total of 1000 above and another total of 1000 at the bottom to give an overall net depth of 2000 atoms. Do note that both of the answers are accepted for this particular question because it's open for interpretation, but I'll start off first by going with this particular interpretation first, and then after that we can try out the method for the second interpretation. So first thing first, we want to measure what is the area of square piece of copper. Right, that will actually be 0.1 square meter square. The reason here is I want to find out how many copper atoms is needed to fully cover one side of this square piece of copper. So the number of copper atoms required to cover square piece of copper for one layer, it would then actually be the area of the square piece of copper divided by the area of the copper atom. In this case here, it would be 3.0 times 10 to the power of negative 12, but we will have to square it because we are now assuming that this copper atom itself is existing as a cube, and it does comes with a cubic length of 3 times 10 to the power negative 12 meter. I'm only interested in the surface area, so I don't need to cube this to find the volume of this copper atom because we are assuming that there's relatively no thickness to be considered. And through this, we'll end up by having 1.11 times 10 to the power of 21 copper atoms just for us to form a single layer. But again, we are now looking for 1,000 layers, so the number of copper atoms for 1,000 layer, it will then be equals to 1.11 times 10 to the power of 21 multiplied by 1,000. So this will end up with 1.11 times 10 to the power of 24 copper atoms. Alright, and with that being said, we want to go and find out the number of moles because we are trying to relate to Q is equals to IT. So first thing first, the number of moles of copper atoms of such an amount, it would then be 1.11 times 10 to the power of 24 divided by our Avogadro's constant of 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23. So to round it to 4SF, we will be able to get 1.846 moles of copper atoms are actually required. Now, understanding again that in the whole electrolysis process, we're using copper 2 sulfate, so the charge of the copper ions is actually 2+. Copper 2 plus aqueous plus 2 electrons will actually give us copper solid. And based off the following ratio seen over here of 2 itself, that will mean that I will need 2 Faradays to discharge 1 mole of copper. Now, each Faraday itself is given at a value of 9.65 times 10 to the power 4 coulombs per mole. So that means 2 times 96500 coulombs to discharge 1 mole of copper. But since we're not dealing with 1 mole of copper, we have 1.846 mole of copper. That will mean that it will be 296500 divided by 1 times 1.846 coulombs to discharge this particular amount of copper. So once we manage to get this net charge, we're going to now relate it back towards Q is equals to I times T, because the question wanted us to find out how long would it take for a current of 4 ampere for this particular event to happen. So for the case of Q now, it's going to be 2 times 96500 over 1 times 1.846 will be equals to the current of 4 ampere, and the time itself has to be given in seconds. So with that itself, the question did, however, indeed wanted us to convert towards hours, right? And we do have a second equivalent. So after doing this calculation, T itself, if we convert it to hours, it will actually be given as 24.7 hours, making B to be as the correct answer over here. Now, however, this is for the first interpretation over here. Now, however, if we were to interpret it the other way, whereby there is a total depth of 2000, then definitely the time taken over here will actually be 24.7 multiplied by 2 to give us 49.4 hours, making C to be the correct answer if we were to interpret it in the second way. So for the first way, answer will be 24.7. For the second way, we're going to double out the time to be at 49.4 hours. Both answers are accepted because of the ambiguity in the phrasing of the question itself.